shit. I don't care about hell anymore because I've been there. I really have. Fucking hell, what a nightmare. It was like, getting up in the morning if you weren't working, it didn't matter whether you were working or not, you still had to get up in the morning because you had to get your fix and you had to go to the off license, and the bloke there just gave me this stupid grin as if to say, oh yeah, here you go. Junkie. Probably worse than a junkie. This is when I was living in Brixton. And you weren't drinking for the pleasure of it. You were drinking because your body needed it. And I'm going to be recovering from it for the rest of my life. But sober. Let me start off by saying, I didn't become a fully fledged alcoholic until I was about 16, 17. My mother, I can't blame my mum, she just gave me wine with water with wine, which is the thing to do with French kids. It's a disease, it's like cancer. It's not something that you just get because you drink too much. Mm-hmm. It's genetic. It's part, nobody really knows, but it's a disease and there's no cure. The only cure, there is no cure. You just have to stop drinking. I drank like a fish until I was 38 years old at university, work, I got chucked out various jobs for being drunk. I woke up in strange women's beds. I woke up in the middle of the road countless times. I didn't know who I was. I think there was something here. I didn't feel judged by society because I didn't fucking care. I don't blame my behaviour when I was an active alcoholic on me personally, because it was a disease, but that's a bit of a cop-out. When I was 38, I knew I was dying, right? I was living in Spain, I came back here to die. Luckily, my mother was still alive. She talked to my doctor, and believe it or not, in those days you could get a good doctor. He couldn't do anything for me, but he could get me a psychiatric nurse who would give me one-to-one counselling. That was once a week, twice a week. I didn't even have to go to a hospital. I had to detox. Then after about 3 months of that, It's not a fast process. It's a very, very, very intrusive illness because it affects your brain and it affects all your organs, but mostly your brain. After that, I started group therapy. We went to this shithole in Load Lane. There was about five of us. And we just sat and quiet. We were all in the same stages of alcoholism, early stages. Then, after a few weeks, a few months, we started sitting up and we started looking at each other. And we started communicating. And we started telling each other problems. And after a while, it didn't become problems about alcohol. It became problems about living. And after a year or 2 years or 3 years, it didn't just become a question about living. It became a question about living properly and with dignity. And I've tried to keep that up ever since. And I've slipped a bit here and there. I'm not perfect. I really fucking hate people who just say, "Oh, you're an alcoholic." And you immediately, not you, they immediately think under a bridge with a fucking bottle of cider. I mean, up to the age of 13, it was okay. I could handle, go down to the pub, having a few pints. But I also had to have that one extra. And then it became two extra, then three extra. Then I couldn't talk to women without being pissed. When I was about 21, 22, after I'd finished graduating, I just couldn't function. I was drinking bottles of vodka in the morning. Well, little bottles. Because I hated my. It doesn't matter. I hated my job so much, but it could have been the best job in the world, and I'd still have been drinking that bottle of vodka in the morning. And then, when the effects wore out about 11 o'clock, I'm just going out to lunch. Where do you think I went? The pub. And then I struggled through the afternoon, and then I went out at night. And I hated my life. And I think the only way I got through it was because I didn't hate myself. When I was an active alcoholic, I was found under bridges, I was slurring my words. People weren't talking to me. I didn't understand why. I couldn't understand what was happening to me. I didn't know I was an alcoholic. I thought there was something wrong with me. I don't know how I got out of it, just by the grace of a higher power, if you don't believe in God. And look, I'm doing a fucking degree. I'll get a crap mark, but Okay, so sometimes I'm not happy to be alive in the morning when I wake up first thing, but life is enjoyable. And the thing is, I'm still. You'd expect after all that therapy and all that that I'd be quite nice to people. I'm still a wanker to people. Because I just don't trust people until a certain amount of time and acceptance.
You know what? There's groups for alcoholics. There's even groups for people with just one arm. Because they empathise. And through them, you learn 100 times more than speaking to doctors and psychiatrists. With the exception of this fantastic psychiatric nurse that I had when I first came to this country, who referred me to group therapy. And for me, group therapy is the key. And that's it.
One of my best friends at the group we hit it off. Is that recording? She's got a red light.
Yeah, it is.
He was crazy.